Great Sunday morning. I hope you're having a beautiful beginning to yet another glorious worship day that the Lord has blessed us with. Look at the sunshine, March 8th, 2020. We're in Proverbs 8. Maybe you're waking up in a tizzy or maybe chaotic or a little stressed because of the loss of an hour. We get greater, light at the end of the day, but still, maybe you woke up and you really felt that loss of sleep, that 1 hour. Well, whatever time you get out of bed, whatever time you start your routine, verse 17 of Proverbs 8 said, I love them that love me. This is the Lord speaking of wisdom when we search his attributes. And it says, and those that seek me early, early in the morning, early in the day, early in life, as a priority, shall find me. So when we put the Lord's desires first, then we will see that our day is ordered. His priorities are orchestrated already. And as long as we follow him, we have his favor. And like I said, maybe you start off kind of crunchy, but in John 14:21, it says, he that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father. So it's a two-way deal. And I will love him and will manifest myself to him and her. I will show them my will throughout the day. I will unfold the blessings and the way of prosperity every single step of the way. And it's a good idea just to get out into nature and just to worship the Lord. And it says that wisdom is even there. In verse 23 of Proverbs 8, it says, I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning or ever the earth was, when there was no depth. I was brought forth when there were no fountains abounding with water, before the mountains. You know how you go on these road trips and you see the mountains and the side of the highways? It says, even before those were formed, wisdom was there. And before the hills was I brought forth, while as yet he had not made the earth, nor the fields, nor the highest part of the dust of the earth. When he prepared, God prepared the heavens, I was there. That's why it's so important to seek the Lord's face and his wisdom throughout the day, because that element, the Holy Spirit, was there from the beginning. When he established the clouds above, when he strengthened the fountains of the deep, when he gave to the sea his decree that the waters should not pass his commandments, when he appointed the foundations of the earth, then I was by him as one brought up with him, and I was daily his delight. Are we daily the Lord's delights today, rejoicing always before him? Are we doing that today? Or are we waking up and, complaining or arguing? You better rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Because today is the 8th, we will have gone to Psalms 8 again. O Lord, how excellent is thy name above in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Yep. And it talks about all the elements and how the Lord is mindful even of us. And he has given us dominion and power over all the creation of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under thy feet. And because of that, we can praise and worship him in spirit and truth. Verse 9, O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth and all nature and all the elements that he has created. We also would have gone into Psalms 38. If you have some opposition today, verse 15, for in thee, O Lord, do I hope. Thou will hear, O Lord, my God. Even though you might have like this and that coming at your ear, be like verse 13. I make myself as a deaf man or woman. I hear not, and I was dumb that I open up my mouth. I do not, because I don't want to respond to enemies. And the Lord will give us the power to do that. Even though our enemies are multiplied and lively, rejoice in the Lord and his presence all day, and know that wisdom is with you all the way. Amen. Have a wonderful day of worship. Enjoy his many blessings. Get outside and continue to praise him always. Good day.